حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وقائدنا وقدوتنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، الذي كان أجود الناس وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان حين يلقاه جبريل فيدارسه القرآن. ولرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود بالخير من الريح المرسلة، صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن سار على نهجه واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. ثم ما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. All praise and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Peace and blessings of Allah be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We bear witnesses that there is no one worthy of being worshipped except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his final messenger. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the entire universe. The man who was definitely the most generous amongst human beings. And he would be at his utmost level of generosity, specifically in the month of the holy month of Ramadan. The man who used to be at his utmost level of generosity, especially when Jibreel alayhi salam would meet him to revise and review the Quran with him. Because this is the month of the Quran. As such, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. The month of Ramadan in which the Quran was revealed as a guidance, not to the Muslims or the believers alone, but to the entire humanity. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send his peace and blessings upon him, upon his companions, and all of his righteous and true followers until the day of judgment. And may he subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the company of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and make us among those who are close to him in their rank. And may he subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the shafa'ah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, atakum shahru Ramadan, shahrun mubarak, faradallahu alaykum siyama. It was the practice of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Ramadan is approaching, to give his companion, his followers, the glad tidings, the good news of the arrival of the month of Ramadan. And he used to tell them that Ramadan is approaching you. It is a blessed month. It is a month in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained or commanded you to fast. Now, as Ramadan is approaching, my brothers and sisters, we probably know the very famous statement, roll out the carpet or the red carpet. Now, the question I have to ask myself, and each and every one of us should ask ourselves, how can we roll out the red carpet for the arrival of this special guest, the month of Ramadan. And what is there that can help me achieve my goals, make the best out of the days and the nights of the month of Ramadan? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he talks about real practical tools that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us in the month of Ramadan to help us, my brothers and sisters. Because Ramadan is unlike any other month. It is something special. You know, when we do business in our worldly life, we always look for an opportunity. When we make an investment, we look for an opportunity so that we can make the best or the most profit in our business. And Ramadan for us, it is that annual time so that we can basically hit the highest level of profit and rewards. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us about many different tools. And again, these tools are practical, realistic tools. Real tools, my brothers and sisters. They are not metaphorical. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, تفتح وتفتح فيه أبواب الجنة وتغلق فيه أبواب الجحيم. So, in other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands for the gates of Jannah, the gates of paradise, to be wide open, and for the gates of the hellfire to be shut, to be closed. And this is not something metaphorical. It is something that happens in real. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the angel to open the gates of paradise so that the good doers, those who are seeking Jannah, they can rush and they can haste and they can reap the fruits of Ramadan. It is as though that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you and I, my brothers and sisters, come forward. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in another hadith, yunadi al-munad, ya baghi al-khayr aqbil wa ya baghi al-sharr aqsir, that a caller or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appoints an angel to call upon people that, oh, the doer or the seeker of the good, it's your time to come forward. It's your time to work hard. And the doer of the evil, to hold back, to retract, to make tawbah. Because Ramadan is a golden opportunity. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions more and more of these tools that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides in the month of Ramadan. تُغَلُّ فِيهِ مَرَدَةُ الشَّيَاطِينَ. So the masters of the shayateen, of the devils, are chained to make it easier for you and I so that we can get through the month of Ramadan with the most possible amount of rewards. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues and he says, فِيهِ لَيْلَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. In it, there's a night that is equivalent or actually better than 1,000 months in which there is no Laylatul Qadr. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam concludes and he says, Man hurima khayraha faqad hurim. Man hurima khayraha faqad hurim. Whosoever is deprived, and let's listen to this carefully, my brothers and sisters, whosoever is deprived from the khayr of the night of the Qadr, of the night of power, or whosoever is deprived from the good of the month of Ramadan, then that is, my dear brothers and sisters, that is indeed the greatest loss that one can incur. It is as though that you are becoming, basically, you are having this opportunity to make the most profit possible, then you lose everything. You become not only basically, you know, you lose what you invest, but you become bankrupt. And who could be in a greater loss, my brothers and sisters? And Ramadan comes and goes, and you have not achieved anything in your life. You have not made any change. You have not basically drawn closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you and I do not change and ask yourself this question, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسِ إِذَا لَمْ تَعُودِ إِلَى اللَّهِ فِي رَمَضَانِ فَمَتَى سَتَعُودِي. If I do not go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I do not retract, if I do not cut down on my sins and wrongdoings, if I do not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I do not use the opportunity of the month of Ramadan, when would I do that? Because everything around you in the month of Ramadan is just basically saying everything is made easy for you. The red carpet is rolled out for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made everything easy for you so that you can draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you read the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, my brothers and sisters, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about fasting and the month of Ramadan, you will find that at the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ, that if my servants ask you, O Muhammad, about me, tell them, inform them that I'm close, that I'm near. Let them draw closer to me. Let them call upon me. It's our opportunity, my brothers and sisters. Ramadan is here. And if you ask, as some people ask, you know, Ramadan for me became a routine. We hear this a lot. نسمع كثيرا أن رمضان أصبح أمرا روتينيا لا فرق بين رمضان هذا العام والعام الماضي والذي قبله والذي قبله. There's no difference between Ramadan this year and the year before. I fast like people fast. I pray like people pray. And I just read the Quran just because everyone else is doing it. Then, my dear, Ramadan is not doing any good to you. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives us a list of basically, you know, motivational aspects that if anyone knows them and if anyone realizes how great they are, indeed, you will not think even once, let alone twice, to make sure that you utilize every second, let alone every minute in the month of Ramadan. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا فقد غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه ومن قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه ومن قام ليلة القدر غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه من صام يوما في سبيل الله بعد الله بينه وبين النار 70 خريفا. What else do we want, my brothers and sisters? Whosoever fast the month of Ramadan seeking, and again I will emphasize on this, my brothers and sisters, because some of us do not pay too much attention or much of an attention when it comes to the matter of niyyah, of intention, because it is very important. Because you could be fasting and your neighbor, your brother, your friend could be fasting as well. But what makes the difference is your intention. He might be fasting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while you might be fasting because you want to have a better body build. You want to become healthier. You will get that, but there is no reward. Why? Because the intention, your intention is not to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You got to make sure that you do it iman and wahtisaman, that you do it with your faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking the reward from Allah. And what is the reward? As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, غفر الله ما تقدم من ذنبه. It is as though that all of your sins are wiped away and you are clean. You're starting with a clean sheet after the month of Ramadan. So in another word, my brothers and sisters, Ramadan is an opportunity for us to basically bring that change that we have been looking for. When we feel, my brothers and sisters, عندما نشعر بطول الطريق وقلة الرفيق والناصر وصعوبة العمل وبعد الهدف وقلة الأمل وكثرة الذنوب وقسوة القلوب وضيق الصدور عندها يأتي رمضان فيعيد فينا الأمل مرة أخرى. When we feel, my brothers and sisters, that the path is long and the objective or the basically the job is very difficult, we feel stressed out, we feel that life is becoming more difficult and tougher, especially that we have been going for almost a year and a half now through this pandemic. When we feel, subhanAllah, that we are reaching a tipping point with, you know, mental health and depression, when we feel that our goal is so far, when you feel that you are getting basically depleted, and when you feel that your hope is getting basically, you know, going away slowly, slowly, and you feel that your sins are so much that you don't know where to start from, what to stop, and how to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when you feel that your heart is getting hardened, Ramadan comes back, my brothers and sisters, to give us that hope again, to bring that hope in us, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again, to grant us that revival of our faith and trust in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remind us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, that we have the most merciful, the most compassionate, the loving, the forgiving Lord of ours, my brothers and sisters, that we need to seek forgiveness and mercy from. My brothers and sisters, before I conclude the first part of my khutbah, Look around you and just think for a moment. How many of our or your own loved ones wanted to be alive again in this year's Ramadan? And they are buried under the surface of the earth. They're gone. How many of us, my brothers and sisters, have heard? كم منا سمع وجاءت الأخبار أن فلان قد توفاه الله فلان توفي بسبب أو بآخر. How many of us have heard this news that, you know, my so-and-so have died because of COVID or because of a heart stroke or because of that? And rest assured that each one of them was looking probably forward to be alive and to make something out of this Ramadan. But they lost that opportunity. They are no longer here. Perhaps, we don't know, my brothers, perhaps this Ramadan will be my and yours last opportunity also. And if you want to know, why is it so important that you make the best out of this Ramadan? Listen to this quick story that Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiallahu anhu Ardan reads, that two brothers or two basically, friends came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They embraced Islam together. One of them was more keen than the other. And he, subhanAllah, participated in an expedition and he died as a shaheed, as a martyr. And then his brother or his friend died a year later after he experienced one more month of Ramadan. Guess what happens? Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiallahu anhu arda, yara fil manam, annahu waqif amam bab al jannah, aw ihda abwab al jannah. Talha ibn Ubaidillah sees in his dream that he's standing in front of one of the gates of Jannah, and someone comes out and admits the brother who died later first. The one who died as a martyr, as a shaheed, is left behind, waiting. And then comes out again and then brings in the other one, the one who was more keen and more effortful, the one who died as a shaheed, brings him next. Then he comes out again and tell Talha ibn Ubaidillah, as for you, you have to wait. It's not time for you. So Talha ibn Ubaidillah, he wakes up in the morning and he goes around and about and he tells everyone, shocked, how is this possible that the man that who was basically less keen gets admission to Jannah before his brother who died as a martyr? And they are wondering and they come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, mimma ta'jabun. Min ayyi dhalika ta'jabun? What is it that you are, surprised about? And then he goes on and he says, didn't his brother live a year longer and he experienced one more Ramadan? Didn't he pray so many or such and such many rak'ahs and made such and such many numbers of sujood? And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues and he says, فَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا أَبْعَدْ مِمَّا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ. He says that by Allah, that the difference between the two in the level is the difference or the distance between the heavens and the earth, subhanAllah. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ سَأَلْ مِسْلِمِ كُلِ ذَنْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُونَهُ وَالْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى ثم أما بعد إخواني وأخواتي في الله my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. I'll conclude inshallah ta'ala with my last point, which is it is time for you and I, before we step out of the doors of the masjid, that we make an intention. ناقد العزم من الآن قبل أن نخرج من بيت الله سبحانه وتعالى ناقد العزم على أن يكون هذا رمضان هذا العام رمضان غير رمضان مختلف. That we are, inshallah ta'ala, making intention between ourselves and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this Ramadan is going to be a different one, inshallah. It's going to be a unique one. It's going to be a Ramadan that we, inshallah ta'ala, have a list or basically a few goals that we want to achieve. Smart goals. Goals that are realistic. Goals that we can, inshallah ta'ala, achieve. And goals that will help us, inshallah ta'ala, to become better servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Goals that will bring, inshallah ta'ala, positive change that will help us to make a difference, not just within ourselves and within our family members, but also in the society. Make a difference, and this is something that it's important for us to share, my brothers and sisters. We are almost at the first day of the month of Ramadan, and we have been hearing about, the rise in the cases of COVID. So if you are amongst someone who has been tested positive, for COVID-19, it is your duty as a believer in the month of Ramadan to stay away from the masjid so that you do not pass it to others, because you care, because you're compassionate, you're loving, because you follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or if you have come in contact with someone who has traveled outside, or somebody who has been tested positive, or somebody basically who has been around someone else who has been tested positive, it is out of caution. Or if you have some symptoms of COVID-19, it is, even if you have tested negative, as a precaution, it is your duty to stay away from the masjid, because you don't want to cause harm to someone else. And that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بِغَيْرِ مَا اكْتَسَبُوا فَقَدْ احْتَمَلُوا بُهْتَانًا وَإِثْمًا مُبِينًا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to be amongst those who make this Ramadan, inshallah ta'ala, Ramadan of change. May He subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the best out of every day and night of Ramadan. And may He subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us, inshallah, forgiveness and acceptance in the month of Ramadan. Sallu ala Rasul al-Kareem wa al-Mabuthi rahmatan lil-alamin. Faqad amarakum Allah bidhalika fi kitab al-Kareem. Faqala azza min qail, inna Allah wa malaikata yusalluna ala al-Nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وانعم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وارض اللهم عن الاربعه الخلفاء الائمه الحنفاء ابي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وسائر اصحاب نبيك اجمعين وعنا معهم بفضلك وكرمك واحسانك يا رب العالمين. اللهم بلغنا رمضان، اللهم بلغنا رمضان، اللهم بلغنا رمضان، واجعلنا فيه من الصائمين القائمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا فيه من عتقائك من النار، اللهم اجعلنا فيه من عتقائك من النار. اللهم عاتق رقابنا ورقاب والدينا وإخواننا وأخواتنا من النار. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار برحمتك يا عزيز يا غفار يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم أثابكم الله.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر.